Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel today. If you're new, welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be a mini Ulta haul. And a couple of these products are repurchases. One of them I've never tried before until yesterday. I wanted to make this an unboxing video, but I needed some of the products. So actually all of them, I needed all of the products right away. I'm just going to be showing you what I got, but I also got a sample pack, which was nice. It was going to be an expensive order, but I did have $30 in points, which was great. So without further ado, let's get right on into the video. For the first product I bought is the Bumble and Bumble Pret-A-Powder. It's equal parts dry shampoo, style extender, and volume in a pinch for normal to oily hair. I know that this is a super popular product from Bumble and Bumble. It's one of their best sellers. The packaging will remind you of a baby powder. There's one teeny tiny little hole right in the middle where the powder comes out, and even the powder looks like baby powder. It's white. There is a fragrance to it. I do not like the fragrance. I've only used this once, and I'm gonna need some tips from you guys, because knowing that this is a bestseller, I know a lot of people have tried this out and love it. So when I tried this out yesterday, put in my hair, massaging it and everything, and there was definitely a white cast. It actually made my scalp look like I had some gray hairs. It was very noticeable, so I really had to like dig into my scalp and do what I could. What do you guys do to make the white cast go away with this product? As far as how it felt in my hair, I'm not really big on dry shampoos. A lot of them just don't work with my hair. I have thicker hair now that I've been taking hair skin nail gummies from FNX. I'm getting used to the thickness of my hair, my scalp area, the top half of my head, and also like right at the back of my head can get super oily super quickly, especially even if I just like run my fingers through my hair, because our fingers always have oils on them, so naturally it's going to make my hair a little bit more oily. It didn't make my hair feel super gunky, like how if I were to put in a spray dry shampoo and if I would try to run my fingers through my hair, then it would feel like gunk and like my hands would be like kind of like stop and go. It would just feel very gross. This one didn't feel like that. I may have felt it like slightly, but I also didn't use a ton of powder. I just used it in the spots where I felt like I needed it most. As far as the back of my head goes, I don't know how it looked. I could not see it, so I don't know if there was a white cast in the back of my head or not. It didn't feel as greasy, which was nice, but I of course have to try out this product more in order for me to give a full review, so stay tuned on that. So the Peach Balancing Cleanser is one of my favorite products. I was gonna say go-to, but it's the only product I use. So this is not a face cleanser, it is a down there cleanser. This does help in every situation, especially because I work out a lot and I don't want the bacteria to just be like sitting there after a workout or in between my shower days. So with this, you only need a dime size amount, maybe even smaller. Believe me, it'll be plenty. You do not need more, because if you do, you will realize that you just wasted a bunch of product. That would be my recommendation. This is also OBGYN recommended. It does not disrupt the vaginal flora. It is safe and gentle. The key ingredients are aloe vera, lactic acid, and calendula extract. Yes, I really enjoy this product. It is a repurchase. So I've been using this for maybe almost 2 years, and it will last me about 7 months because I only use it every other day when I shower or if I need to do an in-between shower. But I think because I'm not using it every single day, it has lasted me a little bit longer maybe than the average person using it every single day. Nonetheless, we all need this. And it does not have any fragrance in it at all, so that is a really, really good key component. And then the other repurchase and the last product before I get into my samples, I did use this, so it's going to be a little bit dirty, but this is the L'Oreal Blend Artist Infallible Foundation Blender. I don't ever use sponges for my foundation. I use sponges for concealer only. I think my mom like bought it randomly and was like, oh, try out this sponge, and ever since I've been loving this sponge. So it is a little bit damp. Like I said, I just used it and it's a little bit dirty. Definitely has glitter on there. There's just something about this shape. It's obviously a little bit more indented than a regular beauty blender. I find that this is more comfortable and easier to hold. Your fingers literally just like rest perfectly on the indentation in the middle. And then also just the way it blends out concealers of all different formulas. I just really like how this sponge performs, so I definitely recommend it. It was sold out for a while on Ulta, so I wasn't able to get it. And I also did not see it in store, so I've been waiting a while. The one I was using before was really bad, really dirty. I tried cleaning it, did not work, so I'm very happy to have a new sponge. And then to get into my samples, I was also going to technically unbox this on camera, but there's something that I used today, so there's that. But I got a nice little bag of samples. The first little thing that I did use, because I actually already use this concealer from time to time, mainly in the beginning summer months, this is the Benefit Cosmetics Boing Cakeless Concealer, and it's in the shade 4 in Can't Stop Light Cool. I typically use number 2. Number 1, even in the wintertime, is actually way too light for me. I don't even use that concealer in the winter. It's just not my favorite formula for that time of year, but I find that it works great in the beginning of the summer months. I kind of take a break in the middle of the summer, and then I might go back to it at the end of the summer. It's just more of like a preference thing, and also depends on your skin type as well. This shade is actually a bit too dark for me right now. My face did get more tan in the last week, so it's like kind of getting there to where it might match if my face gets even more tan, but I did have to go in with my number 2, and then it was too light. I don't even know if my under eyes look good right now, but I hope they do color-wise. You also do not have to set this with a powder. They do not recommend, because this is a self-setting concealer, which is nice. And that's the nice thing about using it in the summer, because you don't want to just layer on a bunch of products. You want your makeup and your face to feel very light and airy and easy, so just taking one less step out of your routine is great. But this is a teeny tiny little sample. It is so cute. The box is also super tiny and super cute. Some of these brands in here I'm definitely not going to be using, based on personal preference and just kind of like what I know about ingredients, and I will let you know which products those are. I'll most likely just give it away to someone who might want it. One of those products being CeraVe Hydrating Cream to Foam Cleanser for normal to dry skin. This is a brand that I don't use and will not be using. I'm sure I can find someone who will want that. It's actually a pretty big sample size, but it's a 10 Miracle Leave-In product, limited edition. I wonder if the limited edition part is the size. I have used this before. I haven't used it in quite some time. I remember when this product was like all the rage. I don't know if it still is, but I know that when I did work at Ulta, this was constantly being restocked in all their different sizes. I have a feeling that it's still being used very much by consumers out in the world. I'm glad to have a leave-in product. I just need to see if this one is color safe, because I had this Hemp's leave-in conditioner and it was great. But then I dyed my hair, then I realized that the product was not color safe, which sucks because I really like that leave-in conditioner, but you gotta be a little bit more careful with your hair. Next, this is the Sunday Riley CEO 15% Vitamin C Brightening Serum. I have used this many times before, and I really enjoy this product. Perricone MD High Potency Growth Factor Firming and Lifting Serum. I love Perricone MD. It's not necessarily a product I need, but I think I would like to try it out on my neck, just so I can see how the product performs. If I see any differences, of course I may not see too much of a difference given the sample size, but I do know that Perricone MD is clinically tested, and also that you see some faster results with their products. So if I do see a result pretty fast, I won't be that shocked because it's Perricone. And then this is a Smashbox Original Photo Finish Smooth and Blur Primer with no tint. I really do not like silicone based primers, which this is one. This is Smashbox's best-selling product and also just best-selling primer. They have a variety of primers, but this one is definitely their bestseller. I want to try it again because I haven't tried it in several years. Even though I know I didn't like it, I am open to trying it again just to see, because I do have some large pores. This is the MAC Fix Plus. These samples are so cute. So that is the teeny tiny little bottle we got there. Oh, that's funny. I actually have a sample of this right in front of me because I still have to give that to someone. But it's the Philosophy, the Micro Delivery Dream Peel. 6% AHA and BHA refining gel. So I cannot use Philosophy products because they break me out. I have yet to pinpoint the ingredient or ingredients that make my face break out. They work for other people in my family. I'm sure someone will gladly take that. I do like Philosophy's body products though. I really like the Amazing Grace Magnolia Firming Body Cream that comes in a big pump. If you have never smelled it, go test it out at Ulta if you're able to use the tester. You will not be disappointed. You will thank me. You will buy it. It is one of like the best smelling, besides the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Boom Boom Cream, it is one of the other best smelling body lotions I've ever smelled in my life. A Saturday night before going out feeling, it feels luxurious when you apply it to your body, and it does firm. It firms really fast. I definitely recommend that product for sure. It's fragrance, just putting it out there. A beautiful fragrance. It smells divine. So I really recommend that one. Just letting you know, I'm not like totally discounting the Philosophy brand just because their face products break me out. They don't work for me, but I do really like that firming body cream. This is the Good Molecules Niacinamide Brightening Toner. It's a little bottle right there. I have used this before, but when I did use it, I couldn't really tell a difference because I wasn't using it consistently, so I couldn't get a full review out of it. It's kind of tricky to get full reviews out of samples. You can only do so much. When I do use this, I will make it a point to use it consistently, so that way I can pull something out of it. Why do I keep doing this? I don't know. I'm not even Italian, but I did live in Italy. This is the Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair Synchronized Multi Recovery Complex. You have no idea how many of these I have, especially from my past Ulta gratises, so I am well stocked on this product, and it is a great product, may I add. Clinique High Impact Mascara in Black, one of Clinique's best sellers, especially in their mascara category. Kind of like Smashbox, how they have a variety of primers, Clinique has a variety of mascaras. I think it also comes in brown, but I got the black one. I think I've tried this and I'm pretty sure I did not like it. I think there's something about it that like made my eyes itchy. I'm going to try it again just to see. And then this is the La Roche-Posay Hylou B5 Serum Concentrate, Anti-Aging Concentrate, Repairing and Replumping. Pure hyaluronic acid. I used to use this brand in high school. It worked for me at a time, and then it wasn't working, and then this huge cycle is using it on and off. I don't really gravitate towards the brand anymore because Dermalogica is my main brand for skincare, but I will try this. And then I think the most exciting thing in this sample bag is the Skin Iceland Hydro Cool Firming Eye Gels. It has one pair of eye gels, and it's funny that I'm excited about this because one, I do not like under eye gels. I cannot stand the way of how they feel on my under eyes. It's just uncomfortable for me, and it like makes me just like want to take them off right away. But these are extremely popular, one of Skin Iceland's bestsellers. They also have a lot of other skincare products, and it's also included every single time Ulta does a 21 Days of Beauty if there is skincare involved, because they do makeup, hair, skincare. This is always in there, and I always tell myself I just need to buy it because it's on sale, it's half off. But then I just don't. I just get the feeling like I'll just do it another time. Next year rolls around, yep, I'll just do it another time. So the fact that I got this for free is great. And now I will finally be able to try it and just figure out if I actually like them or not. That is it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more videos on beauty and health. And click that notification bell if you want to be notified when I do upload, which is once a week. And I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you later. Bye.